you can't, that suppress the immune system. Yeah, another interleukin, which is interleukin 17, and from its name, it is secreted from the T helper 17. It promotes inflammation and increases production of the pro-inflammatory cytokines. Family of interleukin 17 include different types A, B, C, D, E, F. It binds to specific receptors to exert its function. It's first recognized in the gastric mucosa during infection with H. pylori, Helicobacter pylori. So it is new one that T helper 17 that secrete interleukin 17. It is important in the bacterial infection. It is a pro-inflammatory cytokine. As we know that we have two types of the cytokines, pro-inflammatory cytokines that enhance inflammation and anti-inflammatory cytokines that suppress the inflammation. So interleukin 17, it's a type of the pro-inflammatory cytokines. Interferon is consisted from the interferon alpha and beta. That is, and this is type 1 interferon that is secreted by activated macrophage, dendritic cells, and viral infected cells, and inhibit viral replication. Type 2 interferon, which is include gamma interferon, secreted from the T helper 1, cytotoxic NK cell, and inhibit viral replications, enhance activity of the macrophage, increase LMHC class 2 expression, and inhibits T helper 2 proliferation. The type 3 interferon includes lambda interferon. It is upregulates the expression of genes controlling viral replication and host cell proliferation. It's important in general, interferon important in treatment viral infection. So sometimes COVID-19 treated with interferon. So this is a virus enter the cell. This is the viral genome and replicate inside the host cell. So the host cell secreted interferon, and interferon bind to specific receptor, and this made the cell antiviral resistance. So when there is a viral infection, so blockage of the viral replication. This is repeated again. This is the viral genome replicate. And cells secrete an interferon. Interferon bind to a specific receptor, make the cell resistance to viral infection, a blockage of viral replication. So this is the mode of action of the interferon against the viral infection. So some viruses treated with interferon. Another cytokine, which is the tumor necrosis factor, this is secreted from the macrophage, natural killer cell, NK cell, and act on the tumor cell. From its name, the tumor necrosis factor, so it has direct cytotoxicity on the tumor cell. From the main tumor, and the tumor undergoes visible hemorrhagic necrosis from its name, tumor necrosis, and the repression of the tumor by inhibition angiogenesis that lead to necrosis of the tumor, and there is decrease in the blood flow to the tumor mass, which is necessary for the growth of the tumor. Tumor necrosis factor also causes extensive loss weight and loss of muscle and body fat, which is called cachexia, by suppression lipogenetic metabolism. And here some example of this cachexia due to secretion of tumor necrosis factor. This figure shows us the effector mechanism by T helper 1 and T helper 2. T helper 1 secretes interferon gamma that activates the macrophage, and this T helper 1, which is responsible for the cell mediated immunity, and it is has direct inhibitory effect on the T helper 2 that secretes interleukin 4, 5, 10. And this can have downregulation and inhibition to T helper 1, which is downregulation of the cell mediated immunity. And T helper 2 is responsible for the humoral immunity, which is act by secretion of interleukin 4, 5 that act on the B lymphocyte, on the mast cell, on the eosinophil, and the stimulation of the IgE and antibody secretion. Now we have the chemokines. Chemokines are family of small cytokines or signaling proteins secreted by cells. Their name is derived from their ability to induce directed chemotaxis. Is nearby responsive cell. They are chemoattractant or chemotactic cytokines. Some chemokines are considered pro-inflammatory and can induce during an immune response to recruit cells to the immune system and to the site of the infection, while others considered homeostatic and are involved in controlling migration of cells during normal processes of tissue maintenance or development. Chemokines have been classified into four main subfamilies based on their structural characteristic: CXC, CC, CX3C, and XC. All of these proteins exert their biological effects by interacting with the transmembrane receptors called chemokine receptors that are selectively found on the surface of their target cell. So, a chemokine, like cytokine, exerts its function by binding to specific receptors on the cell surface. What's the CXC, CC, CX3C? The members of the chemokine family are divided into four groups depending on the spacing of their first two cysteine residues. So, chemokine classified according to their chemical structure. Thus, the nomenclature of the chemokines is cysteine cysteine L1 for the ligand 1 of the cysteine cysteine family of chemokines, and the cysteine cysteine receptor 1 for its respective receptor. The three amino acid between the two cysteines and is termed CXXXC. C for the cysteine, C for the cysteine, and this X for the amino acid, and a third amino acid. And here the structure of the chemokine classes. This is CC, cysteine, cysteine, and this is 2-cysteine, so it is a cysteine, cysteine chemokine. And here the 2-cysteine, and this is amino acid between them. And here 2-cysteine and 3 amino acid, so X3, because we have 3 X's, which is each X is amino acid, so we have 3 amino acid, and this is the disulfide bond, and this is the peptide polypeptide chain, and this is the structure of chemokine classes. And thank you.